We started the lab on velocity and range. There are some things that y'all need to remember. One thing you need to remember, we're talking about distance. The distance it fell to determine the time of flight. So you know distance is equal to 1/2 a t squared. If you measure your table height and you come up with 30 for your table height, you've measured in inches. It are anywhere near 30. That is inches. We do not want inches. You need centimeters. If you use centimeters, you have to convert the 9.8 meters per second squared, which is acceleration due to gravity, is now 980 centimeters per second squared. Or if you want to use 10 meters per second squared, it's now 1,000. Okay? So make sure you keep everything in centimeters. Do not use the inch side of the meter stick. Once you have that, you have distance, you know acceleration, you solve for t squared. The other issue I see having is you need to find where the edge of the table is on the floor. So how you do this is place the meter stick up against the edge of the table and then mark the back side of the meter stick. Okay? Because the back side of the meter stick will be on the back side touching the table. So that gives you where the edge of the table is. When you roll the ball off, it will land somewhere out here. You want where it first hits, not where it ends up at, but where it first hits. Once you get that location, you measure from the edge of the table that you marked to where it hit. This is your range. It needs to be in centimeters. We're keeping everything in centimeters. The last thing that you have to do is find velocity of the ball. Velocity is equal to distance divided by time. The time is the time you calculate it. Okay, the D is your range. So your velocity is going to be the range divided by your calculated time. You should have a high velocity, a medium velocity, and a low velocity. Because you were supposed to roll the ball with a different force. One last thing I've noticed y'all having problems with is averaging. An average is if you have four numbers, 2, 3, 6, 4. Well, you add those numbers up. So that would be 15 is your total, but to get the average, you divide by the number you have, 4. So 15 divided by 4, that is your average. And that's what you want. These are all the hints for the problems and the lab. I expect the lab write-up due today.